Hello, welcome to my channel. My name is Abhilash and I'm a full-time trader by profession. I have started this channel recently where I share my daily market analysis on the stock markets of USA, UK and Canada, and also share my daily analysis on the important currency pairs like Euro, USD, USD, Japanese Yen, British Pound, Japanese Yen, etc. Okay, so in this video, I'll be analyzing the chart of Euro, Japanese Yen for 4th March 2021, Thursday. So this video is for Thursday only. Tomorrow I'll be coming again with tomorrow's analysis. Okay. So let's jump to the chart. Okay. So right now I'm in the 1 hour time frame and you can see that the picture is not much clear. Market made a high of 129.9, then market started coming down, and after the market is trying to go up again, made a high, then made a lower high. The picture is very confusing. Let's jump to the 4 hours time frame to get a clear picture. Okay, so after switching to the 4 hours time frame, the picture is quite clear. Okay, you can see that market is still in a beautiful uptrend, and more or less market is respecting the 50 moving average, and that's a good news for us. Okay, so So we can go for two strategies. Okay. Let me draw. Okay. The first strategy can be, okay, wait for the price to cross 129.96 level. Once it crosses this level, then you can initiate the buy order. Okay. So let the price, or you need to wait long. Okay. Because this is a 4 hour sir. For that, you need to wait. You need to wait a long time. Let the price go up, up, up. When price will cross this level, okay, then just see how the price is reacting. Okay, if the price crosses this resistance beautifully, comfortably, then let the price or let the market trade above 129.96 level or above this level for at least 1 hour. Okay, let it sustain above this level for 1 hour. Let the resistance become the support, then only you should go ahead and place the buy order. That will be the safest option. Okay, so this can be your first strategy. Wait for the market to cross 129.96 level, then initiate the buy order once it settles comfortably above the level. Okay, that is your strategy number one. And the strategy number two can be, as the market is respecting the 50 moving average, we can see, okay, wait for the market. And right now stochastic RSI is in the middle position, so let's wait for the market to come down. Okay, eventually it will come down. If it starts going up from here also, it will come down. Sorry about the drawing. Eventually it will come down. Okay, so when market will come down, you need to look for two things. First thing is, where is stochastic RSI? Okay, if stochastic RSI is in oversold zone, and from oversold zone it is trying to go up, or it is making preparations to go up, then it's a good sign. Okay, and second thing is whether the market is still above the 50 moving average or not. Okay, so two things are: stochastic RSI should be in oversold zone or nearby the oversold zone. Okay, and secondly, the price should be near the 50 moving average. Then only you can initiate the buy position. Okay, this can be a strategy number two. And the best part will be if you can see some price rejection from below like this. Okay, this. If you see that market is taking support at the 50 moving average, it is getting price rejection from below, it is making hammer kind of a pattern, the stochastic RSI is in oversold zone, it is making preparation to go up, okay, then that will be the sweetest spot to execute the buy order. Okay, as the market is in uptrend overall, so I would not recommend anything to short term market. Okay, so this can be strategy number two. So these are the two strategies. First is above this level and second is at the 50 moving average. Hopefully you have understood, and if you have liked the video and found the video informative, please give a thumbs up and please subscribe to my channel for regular market analysis. You can also check my forex analysis playlist on my YouTube channel for analysis of the other currency pairs. And please do not forget to subscribe my channel for market analysis. I'll be coming again tomorrow. See ya. Bye bye.